Hello students, welcome to Nageshkar's Ghee Orchid channel. I am Veena teacher, teaching you 4th standard maths. Now, what we have solved in our last session? Yes, we have started exercise 2.8. A question we have completed. I hope you all have solved B question also in your rough book. Let's cross-check your answers along with me today. Okay, now we will solve B question. Exercise 2.8 B question. What is the B question, students? Subtract, isn't it? First one I will solve. What is the first one? 17.32 from 18.51. Okay, we have to subtract this number. So, see which is greater, 17.32 or 18.51? Of course, 18.51. But still, see the question also that we have to subtract this number from this. So, first write this number. Both the numbers are like decimals. So, write one below 18.51 and 17.32. Give the subtraction symbol and let's solve the subtraction. 1 minus 2 we can't do. Cut the 1, write as it is. Take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor is having 5. He will give 1. 4 will remain. Now 11 minus 2 is 9. 4 minus 3 is 1. 8 minus 7 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Then give the decimal point after 2 digits. So what is the answer? 1.19. Clear? Yes. Now I will solve fifth one for you. See the fifth one. What is the question? 0.001 from 1.000. See, both the numbers are like decimals. So just write one below. But this number we have to subtract from this. So write this number first, 1.000 and 0.001. Give the subtraction symbol and we have to subtract. Now 0 minus 1 we can't do. So cut the 0, write as it is. Take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor also don't have. So he will ask next neighbor. Next neighbor also don't have, so he will go with the next neighbor, that is 1's place. So 1's is having 1, he will give 1, here 0 will remain. Now 10's is having 10, so he will give 1 to 100 and here 9 will remain. Now 100's is having 10, he will give 1 to 1000 and here 9 will remain. Now 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 minus 0 is 9. 9 minus 0 is 9. And 0 minus 0 is 0. Give the decimal point after 3 digits. After 3 digits. So what is the answer? 0.999. Clear? Very good. Next. 8th one I will solve for you. See the 8th one. 26.555. from 26.6. Now see, these are like decimals? No, not at all. These are not like decimals. So first, what we have to do? We have to change into like decimals. See, 3 decimal places are there. So 26.6 means 26.600. Two zeros I have added because after the decimal point 3 digit, here 1 is there. To convert into 3 digit, just add 2 zero. So this number we have to subtract from this number. So right here, 26.600, then take next 26.555. give this subtraction symbol. Now let's solve the subtraction. 0 minus 5 we can't do, then cut the zero, write as it is, take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor also don't have, go with the next neighbor. This neighbor is having 6, he will give 1, here 5 will remain. Now this neighbor is having 10, he can give 1, he will give 1, here 9 will remain. Now 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 5 is 4. Now 5 minus 5 is 0. 6 minus 6 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. Then where we should give the decimal point? After 3 digits. So after 3 digits, give the decimal point. Clear? Understood? So what is the answer? 0.045. Yes. Now 10th one I will solve for you. Now see the 10th one. 10.001 from 101.1. See, this is the question. Now this numbers also not like decimals. So first we need to change into like decimals. So after the decimal point, 3 digit, this number also we have to change into same. So 101.1 means 101.100, isn't it? Yes. So this number we have to subtract from this. So this number means, just now we have changed into decimal, 101.100. Now subtract this number, 10.001. Give the subtraction symbol. Now let's subtract. 0 minus 1, we can't do. Cut the 0, write as it is. Take borrow from neighbor. So neighbor also don't have, he will go to next neighbor. Now this neighbor is having 1, he will give 1, 0 will remain. Isn't it? Now this neighbor is having 10, he will give 1, here 9 will remain. Now 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 minus 0 is 9. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. Whenever you subtract 1 from 0, 1 will remain as it is. And 0 minus 1, we can't do. So cut the 0, write as it is, take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor is having 1, he will give 1, 0 will remain. Now 10 minus 1 is 9. And here 0 as it is. Give the decimal point after 3 digit. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, decimal point. So what is the answer? 91.099. Clear? Yes, very good. Last 12th one example I'll solve for you. 10.09 from 100.009. Now see this number also we need to change into like decimal. Here after the decimal 3 digit is there, here after the decimal 2 digit is there. So we need to change this number. 10.09 means 10.090. Now see after the decimal 3 digits are there. Okay, so we need to subtract this number from this. So write this number first, 100.009. Now write this number, give the decimal point 1 below, write after the decimal point 090, then 1's place at once and 10's place 1. Then give the subtraction symbol. Then let's subtract this number. 9 minus 0 is 9, will remain as it is. 0 minus 9, we can't do. Then cut the 0, write as it is, take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor also don't have, he will go to next neighbor. This neighbor also don't have, he will go to next. This neighbor also don't have, he will go to next. Now 100 is having 1, he will give 1, here 0 will remain. Now 10 is having 10, he will give 1 to the 1s and here 9 will remain. Now, once is having 10, he can give 1 to the 10ths. So he will give 1, here 9 will remain. Now tens is having 1, he can give 1 to the hundreds. So he will give 1 here, 9 will remain. Now 10 minus 9 is 1, 9 minus 0 is 9, 9 minus 0 is 9, 9 minus 1 is 8, and 0 as it is. Give the decimal point after 3 digit, 1, 2, 3. So give here. So what is the answer? 89.919. Clear? Understood? Yes, very good. Now we will move to the next concept. See, here also they are given while doing the subtraction, subtraction of decimal, where you can commit the mistake. So three students were asked to subtract 2.75 from 30. So put a correct on the correct answer. Can you point out the mistakes in the other answer? We will point out the mistake. Now see first one. See first 2.75 and 30. See, these are not like decimals. 2.75 is there and only 30 is there. So 30 we need to convert into like decimal. So 30.00. See, 30.00. Now we got both the numbers are like decimal. So which is greater? 30 is greater. So we need to subtract 30 minus 2.75. So 30.00, 2.75. Now 0 minus 5, we can't do. Cut the 0. Write as it is. Take borrow from neighbor. Neighbor also don't have. Go to next. Neighbor also don't have. Go to next. This neighbor is having 3. He will give 1. 2 will remain. Now this neighbor will give 1. Here 9 will remain. Now this neighbor will give 1. Here 9 will remain. 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 7 is 2. 9 minus 2 is 7. 2 as it is. After 2 digit decimal. After 2 digit decimal. So what is the answer? 27.25. What do you think? He solved correct? Yes, exactly. He have solved correct. Now see the next one. Now 30 minus 2.75. See here, this student, he had not given the decimal point at all. Actually he have not changed into decimal. So totally this answer will be wrong. First you need to convert, you need to change into like decimals. Now see this one. Now this students, what he have done? He have written in the correct place. Ones place, tens place. Correct he have written all the numbers. But what is the mistake here? He have not given the decimal point and 00. So he have written 75 as it is. So this is totally wrong. He is supposed to give the decimal point and 00. Then he should subtract. Isn't it? So that's why this sum also wrong. Understood? Mistakes? So this mistakes you are not going to do. Okay? Very good. Now next. Applications of the decimals. Now using the decimals, make calculation in money and metric measurements. Very simple. Now you know that 100 paisa means 1 rupees, isn't it? So 1 paisa is equals to, in fractions how we write? 1 upon 100. So 1 upon 100 means 1 after how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So write 1 as it is, then add 0, then give decimal point after 2 digit. After 2 digit decimal point, then add 1 more 0. So rupees 0.01. So 1 paisa in the decimal 0.01. So 10 paisa will be 10 upon 100. So rupees 0.10. See, write 10 as it is. 2 zeros are there, then give the decimal point after 2 zero, then add 1 more 0. So rupees 0.10. if 5 rupees and 50 paisa is there, how you convert into decimal, students? 5 is a whole number, so we write as it is. 50 paisa, so 1 paisa means 100, sorry, 1 rupees means 100 paisa. So 50 upon 100. So 50 right as it is. Give the decimal point after two digit. Why? Because two zeros are there in the place of denominator. And after two digit, give the decimal point and write 5 as it is, whole number. So rupees 5.50. Now see the last one. 2 rupees 8 paisa. So 2 is whole number and 8 paisa. See how you have to do? 2 as it is, 8 upon 100. So we will write 8 as it is. We have to give the decimal point after 2 digit because in the denominator 2 zeros are there. Then write one more 0, then point, then what we have to write? Whole number. Rupees 2.08. Clear? Yes, very good. Now see the next one. Now see this. 100 centimeter is equals to 1 meter. You have studied this, isn't it? Yes. So 1 centimeter is equals to 1 upon 100 meter. Means now we have to convert these fractions into decimal number, isn't it? So write 1 as it is. We have to give after 2 digit decimal point because 2 zeros are there. Then write 1 as it is, add one more 0, then decimal point 0. So what is the answer? 0.01 meter. So in the same way, 50 centimeter means 50 upon 100 meter. Write 50 as it is. Give the decimal point after 2 digit. So after 2 digit, decimal point 0. So here they have written 0.50 meter means 0.5 meter. Why? Because after the decimal point, after any digit, if we add 0, if we remove 0, there is no value of 0. So you can remove also. Isn't it? Now see the next one. 10 meter 75 centimeter. Now here 10 meter is a whole number. Okay, and 75 upon 100. So 75 right as it is. Give decimal point after 2 digit because 2 zeros are there. Then give 2 digit after decimal point, then write whole number as it is. So what is the answer? 10.75 meter. Now see this one. 5 meter 5 centimeter. Now 5 we will write as it is. 5 centimeter means 5 upon 100. So write first 5 as it is. We have to give after 2 digit decimal point. So here only 1 digit is there. Write one more digit, then decimal point, write whole number and meter. We can't remove 0 here, okay? Why? Because after the decimal point, after any digit, if zeros are there, we can remove or we can add. Before any digit, we can't. Okay? Clear? Don't be confused here. Now, next. Now, you know that 1000 meter means 1 kilometer. Isn't it? So 1 meter is equals to 1 upon 1000 kilometer. So this fractions we need to convert into decimal number. So how we can convert? 1 upon thousands means 1 right as it is. How many digit after we have to give the decimal point? After 3 digit, because there are 3 zeros in the denominator. So 100.0. So what is the answer? 0.001 kilometer. Clear? Now what about 500 meter? 500 upon 1000. Why we are writing 1000 only? Because 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. So when they are asking in the meter, we have to write in the denominator's place 1000 only. So 500 right as it is, give decimal point after 3 digit. 1, 2, 3.0. So what is the answer? 0.500 kilometer. So they have converted into 0.5 kilometer. Why? Because after the decimal point, after any digit, we can remove zeros. Isn't it? There is no value of those zeros. So 0.5 kilometer also correct answer. Next, 5 kilometer 250 meter. So here 5 is a whole number, right as it is. 250 upon 1000. So 250 right as it is, give decimal point after 3 digit, because 1 is followed by 3 zeros. 1, 2, 3.5, right, as it is. Here again, after the decimal point, after the digit 0 is there, so you can remove the 0. So the answer is 5.25 kilometer. Clear? Yes, very good. Now we will solve our exercise 2.9. What is the 2.9? Write has decimal in the unit given in the bracket. Let's we will solve. I will solve first one. What is the first one? 1 rupee 10 paise. We need to convert into rupees. Okay. So here 1 is a whole number, isn't it? So write 1 as it is. So 10 paisa means 10 upon 100, because 1 rupees is equals to 100 paisa. So we need to convert into decimal number. So write numerator as it is 10. 1 is followed by 2 zeros. So we need to give after 2 digit decimal point. 1, 2 point. And write whole number as it is. Give the rupees symbol. So what is the answer? Rupees 1.10. Clear? Yes, is that clear? Very good. Now next example I'll solve for you, third one. What is the third one? ₹12.90. We need to convert into rupees. Okay, so 12 rupees. So write rupees 12. This is the whole number. Now 90 paisa means 90 upon 100, isn't it? So 90, write as it is. 1 is followed by 2 zeros. So after 2 digit we have to give the decimal point. 1, 2 decimal point, write the whole number, that is 12. So what is the answer? Rupees 12.90. Clear? Very good. Now next. Now I'll solve fifth one for you. See the fifth one. 5 meter 10 centimeter. We need to convert into meter. See, 100 centimeter is equals to 1 meter, isn't it? So here 5 will remain as it is, whole number. 10 centimeter means upon 100, isn't it? So write 10 as it is. Now how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So after 2 digit give the decimal point, write 5 as it is. 5.10, what you have to write? Meter, isn't it? Meter. Now see, after the decimal point digit is there, that is 1. After the 1, 0 is there. So you can write this 5.1 meter also. Okay, clear? Yes, very good. Now next example, seventh one I'll solve for you. See the seventh one. 95 centimeter, we need to convert into meter. Now see, 95 centimeter means 95 upon 100. So write 95 as it is, then give the decimal point after 2 digit, because 1 is followed by 2 0. 1, 2, give the point, decimal point, and add 0. write here meter, 0.95 meter. Clear? Yes, very good. Now next two more example I'll solve for you. Now see ninth one, 750 meter, but we need to convert into kilometer. So tell me, 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. So how we have to write? 750 upon 1000, isn't it? So this fractions, so write 750 as it is. One is followed by three zeros, so we have to give after three digit decimal point, 1, 2, 3.0 kilometer. Now see, after the decimal point, after digit zero is there, so we can convert this number, 0.75 kilometer. Clear? Yes, very good. Now I'll solve next example. 11th one. See the 11th one. 10 kilometer. 10 meter. We need to convert into kilometer only. So here 10 kilometer right as it is. Now 10 meter means 10 upon 1000. So write 10 as it is. One is followed by three zeros, students. So we need to give the decimal point after three digit. 1, 2, 3 and decimal point. Nothing is there, so we have to add zero, then write 10. So 10.010 kilometer. See, 0, 1 after zero is there, so we can remove that zero. So you can write this answer in another way, 10.01 kilometer. Are you getting, students? Yes, very good. The last one more example I'll solve for you. See the 12th one. 50 meter. This also we have to convert into kilometer only. So 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter. So write whole number as it is, 50 kilometer. Then 50 meter means 50 upon 1000. So write 50 as it is. How many digit after we have to give the decimal point? After three digit. So 1, 2, 3, then point, then write 50 as it is, then kilometer. See, 0, 5 after again zero is there, we can remove that zero also. So you can write this number, 50.05 kilometer. Clear? Yes, very good. So here we have completed our exercise 2.9 as well as our chapter number 2, the decimal system. Now what is your today's home assignment? Exercise 2.8 B question, remaining examples. I hope you have solved. If you have not solved, solve once again. And exercise 2.9, some examples I have solved, remaining all you are going to solve by your own. And practice the second chapter once again with the 1-1 exercise. We will meet in our next session with the new chapter. Till that time, take care. Bye bye and thank you.